Welcome back to my project. I'm Eric here. From this project, I'm trying to make a useful toy camera with ESP32CAM and LVGL. The reason why I say it's toy camera is because the image quality of not only input but also the output is not that high quality. Outputting images from ESP32CAM to TFT LCD via SPI interface in real time is way too slow. Also, the TFT LCD used here is a very cheap one. I think we can configure all the systems for under $20, including the lithium polymer battery. This is great because especially for students, it's hard to experience various projects on their small budget. So I want to make it possible for anyone to try my project. One more thing is, this project is an open project, so I want to continue to add more features little by little. Okay then, let's get started. Here are today's targets. A 3.5-inch TFT LCD, ESP32CAM, and a hardboard. I got this hardware from my baby's toy. Actually, it's toy cutting board. You can use anything available nearby. The first thing is wiring as usual. Please take a look at the wiring pre-connected one carefully. As you know, ESP32CAM has a few GPIO pins. Not many pins are available. To minimize the number of pins required by the TFT LCD, several lines were pre-wired inside. The LCD should always be on, so it's connected to the power directly. The serial clock is the same as the touch and display, so it's connected too. Also, through the master out slave in pin, it's used as input-output. Please make sure to do the wiring well. It may be a little confusing when wiring. ESP32CAM here. I just changed the 120 degrees wide-angle lens from the normal lens. It's not a big deal. You can use the built-in lens. Because of the length of this lens, I think I need to adjust the height a little between the camera and the hardboard. It's longer than I thought. From now on, I will show you the video of how I assembled all of the parts. You don't have to do the same. All you have to do is making good wiring. Just sit back and watch it. Finally, it's done. It took some time because of the wiring, but I'm glad it came out clean. Let me connect the battery here. The battery is 3.7 voltage with 250 milliamperes. The screen is being out because I already installed the program I implemented. Let's start the basic LVGL programming in the next video. The current screen output resolution is 320 by 240 QVGA. To be honest, toy cameras are much better qualities these days. It's insane, but we can develop our features for our own camera. So I hope you like it this way. Okay then, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.